I viewed a video of South Africa showing Mandela with his countrymen. They were chanting, "Kill the whitey, kill the whitey." Of course, I'm putting this into English. I know the news portrays him as a gentleman, always for peace. But as we have all come to know, the news is slanted and does not report the real news. This is a spirit that is killing the white farmers daily in their country. All this is kept out of our news, as well as most of the news of what is really going on in our own country, keeping us in the dark and making us the sheeple. This is why Yahweh has called us watchmen to blow the trumpet, so you will know the truth and will maybe wake up. Please listen and know this is the truth that I am speaking. When I was led to look around the net and found another video of Mandela and the leader of Cuba, Fidel Castro, they were together and chanting the same chant, "Kill the whiteys, kill the whiteys," as they all danced around happily and gleefully. Now the two of them were great friends and allowed the spirit to spill over into the two countries. I cannot tell you if I was in spirit or not as I pondered on this. I saw Fidel Castro and the Mexican president dancing and chanting in Mexico, singing and chanting the exact same chant, "Kill the whitey, kill the whitey." I say I cannot know whether I was in the spirit or not because I cannot relocate the video. We cannot just be a sheeple, not understand what is happening here, for this spirit has crossed over into our own country. It has crossed into our border and come into our land and killing our countrymen just like it is in South Africa. We are not immune to this killing. This spirit is running rapid into our own land. We cannot be sheeple and just seek the hand of God instead of sitting at his feet and asking him what to do. The Jesuits are winning in our churches while we are asleep, drinking the wine, making us fat on money and things. While they are planning to steal our country and slit our throats, they are coming across our borders, raping and stealing. As they rape our people, they're hanging victory flags in the trees, showing their victory to the world. How does all of that money now that you saw fill in your pocket? When you should have been looking for souls in the street, loving your neighbor, feeding the hungry, and giving those extra clothes instead of donating them as a write-off on your taxes. Remember that song, "Go Ahead and Hate Your Neighbor"? How does that resonate in your spirit? While the riots will soon be in your neighborhood, when the checks are cut off and there are no more such thing as food stamps, there will be nothing. Now this is hard in the spirit. They will soon start killings everywhere. Stop seeking his hand and get on your knees. I keep seeing in the newspaper, on the web, clips in the news, protection on debit fraud, ID theft. And they're going to say that there's some kind of theft going on, that you need to get chipped. Don't fall for this. It's a lie. It's just another ploy, another trick to get you to take the chip. They're going to say it's for your own protection. But all the while, they're going to do it for take away your rights, to give up your soul. Remember, I told you about the plan of the Rockefellers, and so did Aaron Russo. I have a video of him talking about it on one of my other pages. It's titled Rockefeller RFID 9/11. I'll post it at the bottom of the page. Shortly after Aaron exposed Rockefeller, he fell ill with cancer. Think on that for a while. Powerful man do powerful things.